Video tutorial number 3, perspective with foreground and background. If you remember in the first video, we discussed technique, and then in the second video, we discussed a more abstract idea. Now we're going to go back to technique again. In order to show that objects are in the foreground or close up to you, they must be larger, darker, more detailed, and when you use color, with warmer colors. And objects that appear in the background or in the distance are going to be smaller, they're going to be lighter, they're going to be less detailed, and when you paint with color, they're going to be done with cooler colors. Now I'm going to show you 2 examples of drawings that I have done that will show you about just what I'm talking about. So in the first one, I did some drawings of trees. And as you can see that I drew these trees, I did it the same way that we've been drawing the apples or the idea of round, the reflected light and the curved lines. Now the first tree is the largest tree. It's the most detailed and it's the darkest. Also, it goes from the bottom of the page to the top of the page. So clearly it is right here in your presence. You are right in this scene with it. Now the next tree is a little bit farther back. And the way you know that it's farther back, it's a little bit less big, it's a little bit less detailed, and it's a little bit lighter. And so on as the trees go back. Additionally, I want to show you how I showed this with the branches. Here are 2 branches that look like they're going in the same direction. This branch clearly comes forward because it's dark, whereas this branch goes back because it's light. So this is an example of showing you how the same shape is treated differently, and so you are giving a different information to the viewer. And I have another drawing that illustrates the same thing, but in a different kind of scene. So if you remember the apple that we did, I put the apple on a tablecloth. Now the tablecloth has a checkered pattern. The checks in the front are larger and darker, and they gradually get smaller and lighter as they go back, which gives the illusion to the viewer that the table actually goes back. And there's something else that I want to teach about perspective, and that is called the vanishing point. So if you imagine that there is a point up here where everything emanates from, then that's how you create perspective. So that's how I made these lines, is I made them all emanate from the exact same point. Just like when you think about the train tracks going off in the distance, that's how things are big in the front and they get small in the back, but they all go to an imaginary vanishing point.